Jesus. Amen, amen. Now, there's an old hymn that we used to sing, but we are going to sing it in a bougie way. Tell your neighbor, bougie way. Amen. All right, let's go. Are you ready, band? Yeah, yeah, oh. 3, 2, 1, let's go.
Angels we have had on high, sweetly singing all the day.
Oh, yeah.
And the mountains they reply, echoing their joyous
glory.
Abundantly, we thank you, Jesus. We bless your name, oh God. We worship you, Lord. Hallelujah.
Oh, come ye to bed.
the Lord. He's lifted up. He's lifted up. Years ago or thereabouts, one holy night, you know, every day is a holy night, but that one holy night when Jesus Christ was born and angels, you know, I can just imagine that time, the way the angels were singing. And that is the same when, you know, when Jesus is born in our hearts, the Lord God Almighty and all the hosts of angels, they sing in heaven. So I want us just to sing a sweet melody to the King of Kings and join with the thousands of angels just to hear and say that Christ the Lord is born. Amen. Amen. I don't know how you're going to worship the Lord today. You can fall on your knees. You can lift up your hands. You can prostrate. But just say the King is Lord. And the Lord God Almighty is born. Amen. Hallelujah.
Oh, holy night, the stars are brightly shining. It is the night of a dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till he appeared and the soul felt its worth. A thrill of hope, the weary world rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morn. Come on, fall. To be our angels, the angels' voices, the angels' voices. Oh, night, oh, night, divine, divine. Oh, night, when Christ was born,
when Christ was born.
Let us continue praising the Lord. With joyful lips, praise the Lord.
Amen.
It is important to come before God with a joyful heart, because He dwells in the midst of the praises of His people. So let us learn to come to God with a joyful heart. Let's continue praising God for what He's done for us at this time.
Hallelujah.
He has given us a son. Hallelujah. Shanda la 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 bosikianda. Ore babo shanta kamazia mama kaya. Ore babo shanda la 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 bosikia yanda baboria. Hika mahanda la 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 bosikia. Praise the Lord. I would like us to thank God for the life He's given us this season. He has given us good health and sound mind. It's nothing to take for granted. Good health is something. If you ever work in a hospital, you would thank God for good health. Because when you see somebody struggling to do the little things you take for granted, then you would know that good health is a great gift. Praise the Lord. There's somebody, we have a testimony here. Somebody has been sick of cancer. He had lymphoma. And we thank God because they asked for prayers. You know, when you know the doctors cannot do something and they can only do so much, where else can you turn? There's only one place to turn to, that is to the Lord. And this person asked the church to pray. And God being God, He hears the prayers of His people. If you come before God with a sincere heart, the Bible says that a contrite and a broken spirit, the Lord will not despise. So if you come before God with a contrite and a broken spirit, He will hear you. And this time, He heard our prayers. Praise the Lord. And the person Let me read the testimony. It says, "Dear family, I had the call from the consultant, and it is as good as it can be. Praise God. There has been a complete remission of cancer, meaning all symptoms have gone and there is no evidence of lymphoma." Do you know, we are dealing with a demon that is so stubborn called cancer. One time, a preacher was praying for somebody and he asked a doctor among the congregation, "Doctor, what do you see when you hear people have got cancer?" They said, "When they check, even if they cut your hand, a shadow remains." So they saw like a shadow. It's a demon. It's a real demon, this one. They saw like a shadow where the person had cancer. Meaning, you think the cancer is gone, but it continues. It just jumps from one place to the other. But this one is completely healed. Praise the Lord. Even the doctors have I beg your pardon, my phone keeps going off on its own. The doctors have, there is no evidence of lymphoma, cancer in the lymphatic system in the body. I've only had 2 cycles. God has healed me. So now they will de-escalate my chemotherapy by taking out one of the 4 drugs. Amen. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name, who forgives all our iniquity and who heals all our diseases. Isn't he a good God? We cannot thank God enough. You know, when you have had a cold and you pray God and it goes, never take it for granted, because God likes a thankful heart. There's nothing as bad as, you remember the 10 lepers? Only one went back. And what happened to him who went back? He was made whole. There's a difference between being healed and being made whole. He was made whole. Praise the Lord. Let us thank God for this. Just this one soul that has been healed of cancer. Hallelujah. Shepa kaira mamba dalalala bosikianda. Koriba boshantiriba kaira manta baboria. Kema sanda lalalala boshikianda lalaboka. Korabo siti kaira manda baboria manta babosaka. We thank you, God, for your faithfulness. We thank you for your healing virtue that has flown through this dear son, O King of Glory. And we continue to thank God because we know the good work you started in him, you are faithful to accomplish it, O God. Make him whole, O King of Glory, and let the desires of the parents, these desires, O Father God, be fulfilled in the name of Jesus. We bless you and we give you glory and we give you praise. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I don't know if there's anybody who will be traveling soon. I will be traveling, so I might not be with you for the next few weeks. Praise the Lord. Anybody's traveling with me? We need to pray for those people who are traveling. I don't know if I pray for myself or I'll ask Pastor to pray for me. I can pray for myself, but if Pastor is willing, he can pray for me. Praise the Lord. Amen. But before he does that, I would like to ask to give. It's time to give to the Lord. When you hear people go quiet, there is a place that is touched by the thing called money. And this thing called money is so sensitive. When you tell somebody money, that's the only time they turn. They say, "Did you say money?" It's time to give to the Lord. You know, to be honest, when you look around, to get all these things in place, it costs money. And we cannot emphasize enough how much money we need. Praise the Lord. So it's time to give, and I'm going to pray. Father, we thank you and we give you glory and we give you praise. We thank you for your provision, which never fails. We thank you for the good work of Father God that is started in us, which you are faithful to accomplish. We thank you, Father God, for giving us even good health to work, giving us work to do in the name of Jesus. And it is an honor and a blessing even to give back, O Father God, to you. I pray for every hand that stretches to give, O Father God, that you shall increase from their hands, from their banks, from their pockets, in the name of Jesus. And I declare and decree there is no weapon that is going to be fashioned up against them that will prosper, in every tongue that will dare rise against them in judgment, we condemn it in the name of Jesus. And I declare total abundance in the name of Jesus. The Lord shall supply all our needs according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. I declare so, and let it be in Jesus' name. Amen. The ministry, before you take over, let Pastor pray first. It's not anything we can take for granted to get in a tube. No, I'm not saying the tube underground, the tube to fly and land. Have you ever known that there's nothing you can do when you're up there when that thing goes wrong? Does it ever occur to you that there's nothing you can do but pray?
Okay, let's pray and let's stretch our hands towards Charis. Father, in the name of Jesus, we just want to thank you for your journey masses. We commit Charles before you, dear God, as he travels back to Kenya. We pray for his protection when he's in the air and on the ground. And we pray even as the time that he's going to spend in Kenya, you protect him, dear Lord, when he's moving up and about in the name of the Lord. And we pray even you shall protect him from the virus that, dear Lord, has gone across the globe in the name of Jesus. That by the name of the Lord, that great name that we all learn into and we are saved, we bring him under that name, and we pray in Jesus' name, you keep him. As the Bible says, we are blessed going out and we are blessed coming in. Therefore, we declare no arrows of the enemy will be able to reach him, because God, you are rear guard around him, and it is well with him in Jesus' name. Even as he goes to spend some time with the family back home, we pray it will be a time, dear Lord, for joy, a time of fellowship, a time of blessing, and the time that you're going to be there, we pray that you're going to use him for the glory and honor of your name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
God bless you.
Amen.
David, could we have the lyrics, please? Thank you. The first Noel, the angels did say, was to certain poor shepherds in fields where they lay in the fields where they lay down on a cold winter's night that was so deep.
Noel, Noel,
Welcome to High Heights Church, where we love, grow, serve, and make a difference. Our High Heights Super Kids services, that is the First Luke ages 2 to 6, 252 ages 7 to 10, and XP3 of ages 11 to 15 meet every Sunday from 11 a.m. to 12:30 p.m. Super Kids Global Online Service takes place via Zoom every second Saturday of the month from 2:30 p.m. to 3:30 p.m. GMT. A seamless youth service, a service of young people between the ages of 16 to 24 years. It takes place every Sunday from 11 a.m. to 12:30. Marriage talks continue every week on Wednesday from 7 p.m. to 7:30 with our very own Pastors Peter and Pauline.
Let's go.
Can we put our hands together for our children? That was a beautiful performance. Thank you, the kids' ministry. Thank you, the teachers. We bless God for your lives. That was beautiful. One more time, let's give it up for the children. Woo! Oh, we thank God for that. Merry Christmas, everyone. When the children were wishing us, we all heard, I'm wishing you, I can't hear the reply. Merry Christmas, everyone! Merry Christmas. We thank God for a beautiful day today. It's time to hear the word of God. We thank God for this season. We thank God for the season of Christmas. We thank God for the birth of Christ. We thank God that we are able to see and participate and celebrate God in this season. And before we go ahead, let's say a word of prayer. Our Father, we thank you for the time has come for you to speak to us. Lord, we are ready to listen. We are ready to hear from you. Lord, I'm just an instrument. Speak through me, Lord. Holy Spirit, let your power come upon your children, even as they hear your word through me. I hide myself behind the cross of Calvary. Thank you, Lord, Spirit of the living God. Come down mightily in Jesus' name. Amen. I want to thank God for giving me the privilege, the opportunity, the enablement, the strength to stand here, to bring his word, to use me as an instrument to bring his word to you. May his name be praised in Jesus' name. And I want to thank our pastor, Pastor Peter Kamau, for giving me the privilege, the rare privilege, to stand here and to minister to you. Pastor, may God bless you. May the oil on your head never run dry. May the power of God come mightily upon you, increase you. What you have done this year is just the beginning. You will do more next year and in the coming years. You will grow from grace to grace. You and Pastor Pauline, in Jesus' name. And all Higher Heights members say amen. Okay. Yes. We've been having a series, Christmas series, this Christmas period. And we've talked about the visitation. We talked about last week, exile. Today we have a new topic. I think is the whole essence of Christmas. And we are talking about the fulfillment. Today is the fulfillment. What is the fulfillment? When we talk about fulfillment, what is that fulfillment? What is it all about? Before I go on, let me define what fulfillment is. We are not in a classroom, but just bear with me. let me define what fulfillment is. Fulfillment is the accomplishment of a task. Media, can you just put it up for me? Thank you. Fulfillment is the accomplishment of a task or a plan or a dream or a promise. That's my definition. Fulfillment also is the execution or implementation of a promise. Fulfillment, again, is the actualization or the realization of a plan or promise. Sorry for all the shuns. Fulfillment, again, is the satisfaction derived. You can say, I am fulfilled when you look at things and they've gone well. Satisfaction derived when a task, goal, or a promise is achieved or accomplished. Now, for there to be fulfillment, there must have been a promise. There must have been a plan. There must have been a goal. There must have been a dream. You cannot fulfill nothing. There must have been something promised. When we talk about promise, usually not every promise is being fulfilled. Every promise is bound to be fulfilled, because if you can't fulfill it, why are you promising? But not every promise is fulfilled. Especially with human beings. I'm talking about humans now. Man can promise you something and circumstances will change. It might not be fulfilled. I've promised my kids things, some things, and when I'm not able to perform, there is these three words they say, but mommy, you said, you promised you'll do it. And when they say so, sometimes my heart breaks, especially when I'm not able to. So I'll see myself compromising. I'll see myself trying to go around the situation, you know. And I remember those days. I don't know whether men still or boys still do it now. Those days when a man wants to woo a woman, especially in those university days where the boy wants to woo a girl, they'll tell you, oh, I can cross the seven rivers for you. I can swim across the Atlantic Ocean for you. I can go to the moon and back. I love you more than anything in life. I love you more than my mother. I do this, I do that. You can cross this, cross that. But when eventually such relationship is being taken to another level, maybe marriage, just little challenge, you now tell the man, especially like my husband, come see, how are we? That's when realization will set in. Reality will set in. My husband will sit me down, come, honey, there is something called strategic planning. And And you know, wisdom is profitable to direct. So I'm just telling you, cross a stream, not ocean, not river, cross stream, and he will now bring sense into it, you know. So that is man for you. Human beings can promise you up and down, heaven and earth, but when the time comes, they give all sorts of excuses. But there is one person that when he promises, nothing change. Nothing can change it. He says in Numbers 23, he says, I am not a man that I should lie. God is not a man. He is God. He says he's not a man that he can lie. He is not the son of man that he should repent. When he says a thing, he will do it. And because of the infallibility of his word, because his word does not change, we are here today. We are celebrating Christmas. Do you know what Christmas is? We are celebrating because a fulfillment has taken place. He promised and it has been fulfilled. That is why you are here. That is why you can sit down and call upon him. That is why you can come now and celebrate. That is why you can boast in the face of the devil and nothing will happen. Because he said it and he has fulfilled it. He never failed. Now, when we talk about promise, what is this promise we are talking about? And before I go into that, let me tell you, the devil does not fight the promise. The devil fights the fulfillment. Again, I say that. The devil does not fight the promise. The devil fights the fulfillment. That's why some of us have dreams. We have goals, we have plans, we have projects. Some of us had started, but we couldn't complete. And we ask ourselves, "Whoa, why? Why is it not going through on? Why can't it go through? Why can't I ascend to this position? Why can't I get this? Why can't I finish that building? Why can't I finish that project?" No, no, no. But some of you will even say, "But Pastor prophesied to me that by this time next year, I'm going to be a CEO, and it has not happened. Oh, Pastor, that prophet said to me, I saw it in the dream, and the Lord, I heard the voice of God quite clear that I'm going to get this, but it has not happened." No, you can have all the promises. You can have all the dreams. You can have all the prophetic declarations. You can even declare unto yourself faith words. The devil will not stop you. He will look at you. Go on. But to actualize that thing, to fulfill it, that is where he will be waiting for you. And there is a big gap between promise and fulfillment. It's just like point A and point B. There is point A, the promise. There is point B, the fulfillment. But in between, the devil is waiting. You cannot cross from the promise. He will not stand there at the promise. He will stand in between so that you don't get to the fulfillment. And that is where some of us lose it. That is where some of us fail. When we have waited for so long. Sometimes the waiting period for some, it varies. For some it could be days, months, 6 months, 1 year. While for some it can take years. Abraham heard from God, "You will have a son. Not only a son, you are a father of nations." But he waited for 25 years. The promise of Jesus, the promise was made that Jesus would be born. But hundreds of years went by before that promise came to pass. And that within that waiting time, the devil does not sleep. Like I always say, you can't be a part-time Christian to fight a full-time devil. The devil does not sleep. He will be working, making sure you don't get to this point of fulfillment. That is what he does. But we lose it. When we don't see the light at the end of the tunnel, we lose it. We say, "Oh Lord, why me? Why me?" That's when that question comes up. We get discouraged. We lose hope. Some of us turn our backs on God. Some of us don't even come to church. That pastor is a false prophet. He said that it will happen and it never happens. Oh, he did not hear from God. Well, why did he say he heard from God? If they don't hear from God, let them not say it. But what you don't know is actually he heard from God. But you, are you hearing from God to wait? You have to wait. You have to wait for that promise. It takes time. It takes pain. Sometimes it's painful. Sometimes you will be mocked. You will be jeered at. You will be teased. But if you wait, you will sing like Hannah. If you wait, you will laugh like Sarah. And may God help us to wait in the mighty name of Jesus. Now, what is this promise we are talking about? This promise that we are talking about today that has to do with that has been fulfilled, that we are talking about the fulfillment, its fulfillment today, is the promise of the Messiah. Man lost it in the Garden of Eden, and God wanted to restore man to that original position, and he promised a Messiah. He promised a Savior. In Isaiah 7, verse 14, let's look at Isaiah 7, verse 14. It says, "Therefore the Lord himself shall give you a sign. Behold, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall call his name Emmanuel." Also, if you look at Isaiah 9, verse 6, Isaiah 9, verse 6, "For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, and the Prince of Peace." Now, why did this promise come to be? Why did God give these promises in Isaiah? Isaiah 7, verse 14, and Isaiah 9, verse 6. First, something happened, like I mentioned, in the Garden of Eden. Then God said something in Genesis 3, verse 15. If we look at Genesis 3, verse 15, when God was cursing the serpent for tempting man, God told him that there will be an enmity between you and the seed of the woman. Her seed, you shall bruise his heel, but her seed shall crush your head. Her seed shall crush your head. Since the day the devil heard that, the devil wanted to be the crusher. The Bible says he will bruise the woman's seed's heels, which he did to Jesus on the cross of Calvary. But the Bible also says that Jesus and we, the heirs of Jesus, will crush the serpent's head. Since that time, the kingdom of hell never rested. They fought that fulfillment. They fought that this thing should not come to pass. And they were waiting. They were waiting for the fulfillment to come to be. All the prophets came. Isaiah, Ezra, Ezekiel, Daniel, they all prophesied about the birth of Jesus. They all prophesied about the coming Messiah. Hundreds of years passed by. I don't know what you're going through, and you think time had gone. I don't know what you're going through, what you're waiting for, and you think, oh, it's taking too long. God is faithful. He says he watches over his word to perform it. No matter how long it takes, that dream must come to reality. No matter how long it takes, that project must be completed. No matter how long it takes, that goal must be completed in the mighty name of Jesus. When the promise was given, when it was time for that promise to be fulfilled, there is always a time for a promise to be fulfilled. When it was time for that promise to be fulfilled, there were stages for the fulfillment. Fulfillment is not automatic. It takes stages, and you must be in the spirit to know that this is the season of my fulfillment. You must have the Holy Spirit in you to hear from God that, oh, that time has come. That was why the sons of Issachar in the Bible, they were incredible people. They were people of honor, people of favor, because they understood the times. You have to be a man of the spirit. If you are here and you have not accepted Jesus, you don't have the Holy Spirit in you, the first thing before you go about praying about that project is to have the Holy Spirit in you, that spirit of discernment, so that you know when that stage of fulfillment has started, because there is always a starting point to fulfillment. So there were stages, there were steps for the fulfillment of the Messiah. The first one was the visitation. The visitation. And we look at Luke chapter 1, verses 26 to 27. It will be put up on the screen, but because of time, I may not be able to read it out. Luke 1, 26 to 27. And Matthew 1, 19, 21, they all say the same thing about the visitation. I won't tell you how the angel visited Mary and all that. We all know the story, how the angel Gabriel appeared to Mary. God sent him, appeared to Mary, and told her that she will give birth to the Savior of the world. To the Savior of the world. Now, there was a problem. The kingdom of darkness knew that time had come. Oh, this thing that was prophesied years ago is about to begin. It's about to come to reality. What did they do? they tried, they fought to kill that seed. In the land of Israel, in the Jewish time then, when a lady betrothed to a man is found with a child by any man, maybe not her husband, even if it was her husband and they were caught in fornication, there was a penalty and that was death. But in this case, it was even worse. And that is in Deuteronomy 22, 23 to 24. You can read that when you get home. When a lady betrothed to a man is found to be with a child for another man, that lady is stoned to death. One is a public shame, shame to the family, shame to the lady, and eventually the lady will die. Joseph didn't want to be part of this. Already it was the plan of God that this baby will have an earthly father. It was prophesied that the child will come from the tribe of Judah. He will be a son of David from the tribe of Judah. Joseph was the right man for the job. Now Joseph is backing out. Joseph said, like Nigerians would say, I no do again. please. But Joseph was a gentleman. I like Joseph. Joseph said, Mary, I love you so much. Let me secretly just go. Let me go my own way, but I don't want to shout it. Just go. Because he knew what was involved. He didn't want to be part of it, but that was not God's plan. Whatever it, when God has says a thing, whatever he will do to bring that plan into reality, he will do. He used an angel to appear to Joseph. Whatever God has planned for you, whatever it will take, even if you're, is your enemy, even if it is that tough boss in the office, even if it is that man outside, even if it is strangers on the street, whatever it will take for him to bring that thing into reality, he will bring it. I've given a testimony here where I went to the shop and somebody came to pay for my goods. I never knew the person. The person said, I was led. I was just led to pay for your goods. God can use anything, anybody, to bring what he has promised. Don't underestimate God. God is too powerful to even imagine how he works. The Lord appeared to, an angel appeared to Joseph. He said, Joseph, don't be afraid. He knew that Joseph was scared. And when God wants to address your issue, he doesn't address that sickness. You may see it as malaria, but God is addressing the demon there. You may see it as poverty, but God is addressing powers of your father's house. God addressed that issue. He said, Joseph, what is disturbing you? Fear. Do not be afraid. Take Mary as your wife. Joseph agreed. Everything was going on well. The kingdom of darkness raged. No! They have won. Well, we are still waiting for them. Is it not the seed? That seed, we shall kill it. Remember, the seed was promised that he will crush the head of the devil. If there was no seed, who will crush the head of the devil? So they were waiting. They said, okay, let's wait for them. Let's see how it will manifest. After the visitation, it came, the birth came. That was the next stage. The time of the birth, what happened? There was no room. No room for the child to be born. Mary, a Jewish girl, how can she give birth in the public? Mary, a Jewish girl with dignity, how will it happen? No room for the child to be born. And if she doesn't get an enclosure, an enclosed place to give birth, what if she has complications and this baby dies? Devil wanted to kill that seed. Devil said, let me see how you will get a room. There was no room in the inn. And you know the sad thing? Even today, we still don't give him a room. The world does not give him a room. The world only gave him a cross, but they did not give him a room. And some of us are still not giving him a room. But he's saying, I stand at the door and knock. If any man will hear my voice and open the door, I will come into him. I will dine with him. I will sup with him. I will have fellowship. I will have koinonia with him. He's still waiting for a room. He's still seeking a room. He's still asking for a room. Will you be ready to let him have that room in your body, that room in your heart, that room in your spirit? He's still waiting for that room. Well, man did not give him a room. God says, Jesus told those people, you know, when during the triumphant entry, he told the people that were stopping the crowd from praising him. He says, even if you stop them, God will raise up stones to praise him. Man did not give him room. But animals, the animal kingdom knew the importance of this birth. The animal kingdom knew the importance of this Savior. They were ready to give him their room. They were ready to give him their house. They gave him a stable. They gave him a manger where he was born. The Savior of the world was born. The gates of hell went wild. The kingdom of darkness went wild. Oh, not again. This baby has actually been born. So that seed was not killed. No, not again. And they said, well, let's wait for him. We'll wait. The announcement. Let that announcement come. Let's see. They were waiting. And what was the announcement? The announcement is in Matthew 2, verse 16. Matthew 2, verse 16. The angels made the announcement to the shepherds in the field and also wise men. Matthew 2, verse 16. When Herod realized that he had been outwitted by the Magi, that is the wise men, he was furious and he gave orders to kill all the boys in Bethlehem and its vicinity who were 2 years and under in accordance with the time he had learned from the wise men. When the announcement came, the devil struck again through Herod. The wise men came to Herod and said, we had seen a star in the east. We understand stars. We know the signs. We know the readings that there is a king, a great king has been born. But we don't know the destination. Can you tell us? Remember, they were influential people, so they were able to meet with the king. You know, when I read this place, I always laugh. A whole powerful Herod, King Herod, powerful as he was, heard that a baby king, baby, was born. And he was furious. A baby king, baby, was born. As big as he was furious. It was not about the baby. It was about the title. Brethren, I want to tell you, you don't know what you carry. You might look small. You might be a baby in spiritually. You might be a baby in stature. You might look small, not big, not huge. But what you carry is the authority of a king. What you carry is kingship. You are a chosen generation. You are a royal priesthood. You are a holy nation. God has called you from among his people, and he has made you his own. Some of us, we go about with head bent as if the whole world is against us. If only you knew what you carry. The shepherds, they knew a king was born, but they didn't know the intensity. They didn't know the seriousness of that issue. But King Herod knew a king. Herod will not even, he might not even be alive to see this king rule, but just that word king, that title, the title you carry, you don't know the effect it has on the power of in the kingdom of darkness. That title, Christian, that title, a child of God, that title, conqueror, you don't know the effect, the power it carries. If only God will open our eyes to know. If only God will open our eyes to see who we are in the spirit. Some of us, we go about with shoulders broad, with chest out, and we'll face the challenges of life. Herod was scared because a king was born. He said, okay, go and search for this baby and come. Come and tell me, I'll worship him. But God again, that knew how to preserve his plan, God again, that knew how to fulfill his plan, appeared to the wise men through an angel and told them, take another route home. And that star appeared again and led them home. God will bring out things, will bring out people, will give you dreams. Some of you will dream this night. Some of you will see visions. Some of you will hear words from the Holy Spirit telling you, this is the route, this is the road, this is the direction, walk therein. As we enter into the new year, you'll see that project, you'll see that dream come into materialization in the mighty name of Jesus. And that was it. And finally, the redemption. The next stage is the redemption. This is the climax of the whole thing. In fact, this is the purpose why the child was born in the first place, to redeem man from sin. His birth led to the redemption of mankind from sin and hell. The message of the birth of Christ is a message of hope to the lost world. The message of the birth of Christ is a message of hope to the lost world. Redemption. And we find that in Matthew 1 verse 21. Matthew 1 verse 21. She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save, that word, he will save his people from their sins. Also, Galatians that we had read before, 4, Galatians 4, verses 4 and 5. Galatians 4, verses 4 and 5. It says, but when the time, I read from the Passion Translation. I love this translation. But when the time of fulfillment had come, there is always a time of fulfillment. There is a time of the promise, and there is a time of waiting, and there is a time of fulfillment. When the time of fulfillment had come, God sent his son, born of a woman, born under the law. Yet all of this was so that he will redeem and set free those held in hostage to the law. Held hostage to the law, so that we will receive our freedom and a full legal adoption as his children. That was the whole essence of the fulfillment, the whole essence of this promise, the whole essence of the birth of Christ. Satan said, oh, the time has come. We have lost it at the announcement. We have lost it during the visitation. We had lost it at his birth. This is our last chance. We have to do everything to keep him down. He must not rise. He must not save mankind. Oh, God. That means you are so important that the kingdom of darkness will try to keep one man that wants to save you. You are so important in God's eyes. He said you are the apple of his eyes. He says you are engraved on his palms. He says he loves you with that everlasting love. The devil raged because God wanted to save you. And they waited for Jesus. They waited for him during his ministry. Jesus grew up since Herod could not kill him. God directed them through an angel. They went to Egypt at first. When they heard Herod was dead, they went back and they settled in Nazareth. And Jesus grew up like any normal child. We are talking about fulfillment. The devil did not do anything in his growing up years. He grew up. Now, when it was time for his ministry, the whole essence of him coming to the world, when it was time for his ministry, he just fasted 40 days, 40 nights. Even the devil should hear that and run. But that was when the devil started. The devil brought temptations to him. But thank God for his mercies. Thank God for who God is. Thank God for Jesus. He overcame the devil. He defeated him. He won the devil. He was not defeated. He defeated the devil. Those temptations the devil brought, he defeated the devil. The devil said, okay, you've started the ministry. Come along, let's go on this walk. The devil waited until he had oppositions during his ministry, even from people he came to save, the Jews, the Pharisees, leaders of the law, people that said they knew God, they protected God's law. He had oppositions from them. And the devil waited until the time came when the real thing had to come in, the deliverance of the world. Jesus had to go to the cross. It was destined for him. It was said that he will do that. He went to the cross. The gates of hell rejoiced. Satan and his hosts rejoiced. Yes, we've got him this time. He cannot escape. He cannot escape. They waited. Jesus was dead. Jesus was buried. The devil said, he's buried now. This man, we don't trust him. Soldiers, he went through the soldiers. You know, everything we do, there is a spirit. Either you are being controlled by the spirit of God or you are being controlled by the spirit of devil. Everybody in the world, there are two spirits that control. Either this or that. The devil controlled Pilate and the rest of the Jews. Not only did they bury him, they sealed up the grave. They sealed everything. Then after sealing the tomb, they still had to keep watch. They kept valiant soldiers there to keep watch over him because anything could happen. But when it was time for that fulfillment, on the third day, Jesus rose up from the dead. The grave could not hold him. Satan could not hold him. The tomb, the ceiling of the tomb could not hold him. Nothing could hold him. He rose up. No wonder Jesus was so proud when he was going back to heaven. He said, all power is given unto me. That is the words of a valiant soldier. That is the word of a conqueror. Somebody that has fought and won the battle. A proud warrior. You know, when you win, you know, when you know what is with you, what you carry, you are confident, you are boastful. He said, all power is given unto me in heaven and on earth. And he said, I've given you that power. Go and make disciples. And listen, lo, I am with you. Nothing can stop you. It's just like the queen telling somebody, go and do anything there. I am with you. That is an open check. You can do anything. Jesus said, go. I am with you. Let me see who can stop you. Let me see who can challenge you. We have this victory. We have this confidence. Then why are we downcast? God has given us the freedom. God has given us the power. God has given us everything. He said he has given us everything to enjoy. The redemption of Jesus has brought us hope. He brought hope to the world. He brought hope to dying souls. I don't know how many of you are here and you've lost hope. Hope spiritually. Hope concerning that physical project. Hope concerning that job interview. Hope concerning that job, that climbing up the ladder. Hope concerning whatever. Some of us, we have buildings. Some of us, and we can't complete. Some of us, we have things that we know we should, but we are being restricted. We are being limited because of lack of resources or one thing or the other. Today, God has given you hope. He has come to bring fulfillment into your life. He has come to restore you. He says, he has come to restore you. He says in Job 14, verses 7 and 9. Job 14, verse 7 to 9. I read, for there is hope for a tree. If it is cut down, it will sprout again, and its new shoot will not fail. Its roots may grow old in the ground, and its stump die in the soil. There is hope. You may think you have been cut down. You may think I've abandoned that project. You may think my life, no, nothing good can come out of me. They told Jesus, can anything good come out of Nazareth? But that same Jesus, something good came out of him. You may think nothing good can come out of you. But the Bible is telling us today in Job 14, verse 7, that there is hope for a tree. Even though it has been cut down, there is hope that it will spring forth. There is hope that it will rise and it will grow again. I assure you this morning, I bring the word of God to you. You will rise again. You may not look it, but you are it. You may not look like a CEO, but you are it. You may not look healthy, but you are it. You may not look like a house owner, but you are it. Whatever God has promised you, and you think it will not come to pass, pick up that shackle. Pick up the pieces. Pick up the pieces of your broken hope. Pick up the pieces of your distressed heart. Put them together. Hand them over to God. There is hope for you. May God bless us, even as this word continues to ring in our hearts. In Jesus' name, and I'll call on our pastor to come and pray for us. Amen. While the pastor comes up, can we rise up this morning? God came to give us hope. You may be here, you have not received him as your Lord and Savior. He is standing at the door of your heart, knocking lovingly, pleading, lovingly and pleading that you open up for him. Maybe you have accepted him, but when it comes to fulfillment of your dreams, you've lost all hope. God is here. The Holy Spirit is here, ready to turn things around for you. Let's lift up our voices and pray.
Hallelujah. I don't know what you've been trusting God for. And just like Sister Grow is saying, you feel there's a promise, probably a promise in your family, promise about your children, any promise that God has promised you. And it looked like a high mountain that you have not been able to close and to climb. You see why the message has come to us today. It's not only about the birth of Christ, but what the birth of Christ can teach us, because God is very current and God is very truthful and very real, even in our present situation and circumstances. And today, probably the reason why you keep on hitting the wall is a revelation God is showing you there's something that you cannot do without him. So the more you call upon the name of the Lord, just like Jesus' birth was a miracle by itself, because a miracle is not needed until there is an impossibility. And today, probably you're hitting a wall again and again. Could it be God talking to you? You can't do this without me. It took a miracle for Jesus to be born. And the same God who did a miracle, he is here in this house and he can do it for you if you only believe him And if you only surrender your life and give it to him in the name of Jesus, amen. It could be a child, it could be a marriage, it could be a dysfunctionality, it could be a trade, it could be whatever it is. I just want you to lift up your eyes and lift up your voices right now before the Lord. It could be something that you have been dealing with for a very, very long time. It took 6,000 years for that fulfillment to come to pass from the Garden of Eden to when Jesus was born. 6,000. God is a promise keeper, and whatever he promised, he have ingenuity, he has the power, he has the grace, he has the wisdom, he has the power to do it in the name of the Lord. Today, if we only surrender it right now in Jesus' name. Come on, lift up your hands right now. Bring that child, bring that whatever it is, let there be fulfillment in the name of Jesus in your life right now. In the name of Jesus, you're not going to die in the wilderness, and anything that is, you know, pushing you away from the promises of God, we address it today in the mighty name of Jesus. The same God who came and intervened in the time of the birth of Jesus and made Mary to skip some steps and even to give birth without the help of Joseph. May anything you are trusting and believing that you need it, may the Lord help you to move further even without it in the name of Jesus. Come on now, in the name of the Lord. Come on, open up your mouth right now in the name of Jesus. Kandala boshia bakayanda. Elikayaza ikanda la babayanda li baba santa. Barikaya ziki ya kere baba ziki ya kezi babona la babiana. Barikayanda iriba baba siti ya mazuka baba kianda. Marira ziki ya kezeke bebeketere marababa zuka ramamashi ya babana. Ah, rabababa kayanta rababuri zeke bebeni karia narizia. Is there anything impossible with our God? If God can heal cancer and somebody be told that you are no longer any cancer cell in your lives, our God can visit you. Your case is very simple. Your case is very easy. If you give it to the King Eternal, to the Everlasting God, his name is Mighty God. When he went to the grave, he defeated the death and he defeated the grave. And when he came, when the dust was settled, he came as a warrior. That's why we call him Mighty God. The God who can we trust with the battles of life. And right now, in Jesus' name, come on now, in the name of the Lord, bring that child. Bring that marriage, bring that relationship, bring that status, whatever it is right now. Come on, open up your mouth right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Arabara sintia mazuka bababa kayanda. Melekerina izika bababa kuria razi ya bakanda libana. Rika tararabasi ya bakuria razi ya bakanda iberi. In the mighty name of Jesus, we release our overtaking anointing in the next couple of days before the year is over. I declare in the name of Jesus, you shall bring forth your Jesus. Your Jesus is your promise. I do not know how. You might not have the Joseph. You might not even have the means, but God is going to help you because God, he is Emmanuel, the present help at the time of need. Come on now, in the name of Jesus, don't give up hope. Don't call yourself the way people have called you, or call yourself according to what you see in your life. In the name of Jesus, that is a giving up spirit in the mighty name of the Lord. Dear the devil, you could have won the first round, but the battle is not over yet in the name of the Lord. Kanda rabo siya bakanda. I pray in Jesus' name, if you are going to win this battle, you have to be a lion-hearted heart in the name of Jesus. Come on now, in the name of the Lord. We are pushing, we are pushing, we are pushing, we are pushing in the name of the Lord. It is mine. It is mine. I'm not going to leave it at the altar of despair and disappointment. I refuse in Jesus' name. Rikasa taiba karabasiya bakanda. Berikeliye saizika baba guria kuzana. In the mighty name of Jesus. Oh God, what a mighty God you are. What a glorious God you are. What a faithful God you are. Worthy of our praise. Worthy of our praise. There is none like you, Jesus. In the name of 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 Jesus. Hallelujah. Let there be fulfillment of any promise that have been delayed in your life in the name of Jesus. You did not hear what I said. Glory be to God. I said, according to the auction of my life, I declare in the name of Jesus, this young man who we are praying for, it looked like an impossible situation. You know things about cancer. I went to visit this boy several times, and the whole family was just, you know,
that were just in a place where they thought, what are we going to do? And we prayed. I went there several moments. So when you hear about a testimony, you know that's why sometimes it is easier for you to believe Jesus rose again. But if you could have seen Jesus like Thomas and you see how he was murdered and his face was disfigured, it will be harder for you to believe when you have gone through the season than somebody who had somebody died and rose again. I was in that situation and I could see the despair and the face that had fallen about this family. And right now we are talking about cancer, God, everything, because God is a miracle worker. Somebody say amen. Right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Amen. Amen. I want you to know that sometimes it will take just a few seconds for Jesus to eradicate some stubborn and situation that have been there in your life in the name of Jesus. I love when they start talking about some people who Jesus will come and say, you know, I have been like this from birth. And some of us, we know some situation we have been dealing with. Actually, we can't even remember without it. But I want to say this in the name of the Lord. The same Jesus who stepped in, he is here in the name of the Lord. He stepped into a man who has been 38 years and he said, today you are going to change. And today in the name of the Lord, I decree, as we are coming across this year in the name of the Lord, whatever you have been waiting for, I want you to call it out in Jesus' name. Everything that you are waiting for, it has an ear. If the walls of Jericho have an ear, your need has an ear. Call it out in the name of the Lord. We are trusting God. Rabba shakara rabba kayanda. Belikeliye zaka baba. Are you there in the name of Jesus? Call it out in the name of the Lord. If it's peace, if it's tranquility, if it's hope, whatever it is in Jesus' name, I decree right now, may the Lord surprise you. May the Lord step in on your behalf. May the Lord fight on your behalf in the name of the Lord. Ramashakara rabakayanda ibarika izikanda. Manderebo siti azika ikendira basi yabakayanda libasete. In the mighty name of Jesus, I decree, as you have come to seek refuge in the house of God, the God whom you have come to worship, the God whom you have come to serve, he shall surely intervene on your behalf in the name of Jesus. I release an anointing for a miracle before 31st. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen. Whatever you have been waiting God for from the beginning of January even up to now, I decree in the name of the Lord, may the Lord overtake. May the Lord give you an anointing for overtaking. In the mighty name of Jesus, you will go back and do the same thing that you used to do and you got no result. But this time around, you'll get result because the hand of the Lord was upon you in Jesus' name. Receive your miracle right now. In the name of the Lord, receive your miracle on behalf of your parents. Receive your miracle on behalf of your children. Receive a miracle on behalf of your people. In the mighty name of Jesus, glory be to God. Glory be to Jesus. Glory be to his name. Rakashata rarabori satara baba kayanda. Rebesiti abakayanda irabori zeni. In the mighty name of Jesus, I declare you are for signs and wonders. In the mighty name of Jesus, you will knock the door and it shall be opened. You will move where people thought you would never move. You will trample under your enemies in the name of you. Trample your enemies under your feet in the mighty name of Jesus. I declare, as you have sought the Lord, so also God shall be with you. May he give you favor. May he bless you. May he be together with you. In Jesus' name, you shall not die, but you shall live and declare the glory of the Lord in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Rakasata rababa kondo rebebe ketere borie sitiri baba zina marashi karabonie setere barianda zina. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 All marriages here in the name of the Lord, I declare in Jesus' name, you're gonna go farther. Amen. Oh yes, in Jesus' name. Any demon that come to attack peace and agreement are in homes, I rise against you in the mighty name of Jesus. And I declare anything that have been following your family, especially when it comes to relationship, I break it in the mighty name of Jesus. I break it in the mighty name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Glory be to God. I don't want you to start calling yourself the way you have seen yourself, the way people have called you. You have a new name in the name of the Lord, because God wants to see yourself of the way God sees you. That's why God continues to repeatedly telling you, you are a new creature, you are a new person, because you can never be able to live a life that you have not imagined. I declare it is well with you. I declare next year you have a property in the mighty name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Yes, in the name of the Lord. Glory be to Jesus. Amen. Impossibilities are going down and you are rising up to the glory and honor of his name. In Jesus' name, come on, let me hear people celebrate in the house of the Lord. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. And amen. Amen. What another beautiful ministry by Sister Glory. Amen. Come on, let's encourage her. Amen. Woo! In the name of the Lord. Glory, you have blessed my soul. Amen. I love the way you expounded the scripture. May the Lord bless you. Glory be to God. Amen. Thank you so much.
Amen. Glory to God. Amen. So as we finish the service, we would want to invite you We would want to invite you to join us, to join in singing this hymn, Silent Night. I don't know. Is it ready? All right. So I think they're fixing it. So we'll be... It will be up in a minute so that we can all...
The Lord saw how great the wickedness of the human race had become on the earth. I will wipe from the face of the earth the human race I have created, and with them the animals, the birds, and the creatures that move along the ground, for I regret that I have made them. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life.
Amen. 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 All right, sorry about that. It's just that Pastor is back.
Amen.
All right. I just want to do a bit of housekeeping for 2 minutes. Will you allow me? Please have your seats for 2 minutes. And I hope you have enjoyed the series thus far. Have you enjoyed it?
Yes.
Please let's appreciate the team that has put this together. There's an amazing team that meets even when it's an odd time during the week, led by Chacha, Bob, Glory, and very many people here that you see, they have led that series. It's been going on. And this afternoon, because we will not be in next Sunday, we are having a recording for next week. So if you want to come to the service this week and next week, you can remain behind. Pastor, we are glad to see you back. We thank God that he has taken care of you. That ministration says you are refreshed, so we are ready for you in the afternoon. Let's appreciate our pastor. So the other one is, yesterday we had an amazing time. Yes, so probably for those who are wondering what was happening yesterday, you can see behind me there, Bob is not collecting something, he was singing. We had an amazing time. Yes, you can see that wonderful team. Amazing, amazing team. Yes, that's better. Yes. Yes, if you're clapping, you can clap. Yeah. Amazing team. Beautiful. Yeah. Thank you so much. Yesterday we had a great time to go out and minister to the people, because this message is not only for us to consume within these four walls, but it is for everyone to hear. And so that, you know, they can all come and enjoy this fulfillment as we are. Amen. So yesterday we were at the High Street, a great team was there ministering in music. We had another great team that was distributing materials. And one of the most amazing things is that they didn't just go blindly. You know, they spent time praying. We had a team going there before yesterday. We had a team going there and praying over the place so that when we go there, whatever we would do there, we are under the atmosphere that works for God, okay? So we want to thank the evangelism team led by James, Governor, and that's such an amazing work. Yes, we can say we have ended the year on a high, okay? Yeah, so because of the recording we have after this service, so the discipleship class will not take place today. You resume back on 9th of January, okay? On 9th of January, you resume. And then when you resume 9th of January, next Saturday, not this coming Saturday, next Saturday after 9th, prepare yourselves for baptism. All right, so we have baptism on the 15th of January. So if you've not yet been baptized, please, this is a very great opportunity for you to do so. The other one is that, remember, when we leave here today, we are coming back on the 9th. No, on the 31st. We are coming back here on the 31st. So next Sunday, we will not be here. We will come back on the 31st at 9 p.m., okay? And we will have an amazing time. We are looking forward to have fireworks. We are looking forward to have a great time to pray, to worship, and to hear the word of the year, okay? All right, amen. So, yeah, that's just about it. May the Lord bless you and may the Lord keep you in Jesus' name. Thank you.
Amen. Glory to God. All right, so I would like to invite you to stand up on your feet as we sing this hymn. Did I just say home? Hymn. I think it's because we are about to go home. The hymn is Silent Night, Holy Night. That's what it means, eh?
Silent Night, from heaven afar.
God bless you. Have a wonderful Merry Christmas. And we will meet you again. Is there anything else? All right. God bless you. Remember, we are having our recording in the afternoon, so feel free to join us for the service of 26. Amen.